You're just a decent fish, huh? Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, rule the water. Go on there. Hey, welcome back to Extreme Angler. An afternoon of catching bass. Now, is it gonna be pads, is it gonna be frogs? Looks like a little bit of a front, a cloud back and forth in the sun. No, today I'm gonna be looking for some schooling fish. Little rodents, some game hogs, maybe rage craws. But I'm gonna look for numbers of fish, potentially on deeper edges, clumps. Now you say, how deep, what's deep? You know, I'm not talking 30, 60 feet of water. When you get into that 7, 9 to 12, it just can be magical when it comes to finding good largemouth and some numbers sometimes. All depends on, you know, what the temperature's like, the bite, the mood of the fish. There's so many intangibles and things change for hour to hour. But today, actually just this afternoon, we're gonna go out, have some fun with some largemouth, soft plastics, vertically, right below my boat. Let's go and have some fun. That's one thing about fishing deeper weed, man. It's not like me fishing a certain dock or an overhanging tree or lay down and stuff. Stump, small lily pads. Out here on this deeper stuff, you can get some numbers of fish. That's why you just gotta keep at it. Have the faith, knowing that either here, there, or your little milk run, the little spots you got, you're gonna get them somewhere. Keep returning to productive spots. Use the right baits, and that deep weed pay off big time. Little guy. Little guy's in the weed, huh? Little guy's in the weed. But where there's little guys, that sometimes gives you an indication that you're in the right locations for big guys. Look how he's eating it too. They're fat little ones too. Fat little bass. Chunky little ones. But sometimes that'll follow the edges, you know, your instinct. But I want to find those fish that are somewhat schooling up, those big ones, on the offshore stuff, 8 feet to 12, 13, 14, and potentially getting more than one on a couple drops. But if I get big ones, I'll be happy. But you got to follow your instinct. Inside edges, outside edges, contour, follow it, find the fish, take your time, because once you do on that offshore stuff, you usually get some numbers. Let's try. When you're watching that bait go down, you want to keep that bait falling where you pitched it. If you reel in too tight like this to watch your line in a pendulum, you miss the whole spot. You might want to fish an edge of a weed, a little bit of contour or a black hole. You keep that line too tight, the bait's going to pendulum back to you, you're going to miss it all. Pitch it out, open some line, your rod's up high, and you watch the line go down. A big mistake is when you feel a bite, trying to set like that. Don't. Reel down and then give it to him. Do not want to set when that line's going down because he just grabs it. He might have it sideways. And if you want to set up here like this, you can't set like this. You want your rod to be down here, upward swing, okay? Down here, upward swing. The bait's going down. You're watching the line go down. Don't worry, the fish will not spit it. Let it go down where you want it to go. Shake, shake. You get a bite, make sure it's taut, let them have it. Come here, you little bass. You're just a small fish sitting on the edge of the weed. But sometimes, sometimes they tell you where maybe potentially grandpa is and grandma, huh? Little guys, go on, get down there. Come on, little rodent. Watermelon with gold and purple fleck. Looks sick. Heck, I'd even eat it. Eat it up, man. Sometimes out, a little bit of weather change. Bright sun, a little bit of wind, cloud, something. Barometer changing to trigger the bite. Oh, God. That was a good one. How'd it come off? Wow, how do you come off? Man, that's the thing, you know. You got everything right. Rod, 20-pound fluoral. You can go to braid if you like. All depends on preference, you know. I like that heavier fluoral. Water's got some clarity, but down there in the weeds, you don't see much. If they want to eat, they're going to eat it. But I like a little bit extra stretch. But it's got to keep going. Focus, put your mind, hat down, keep pitching. Keep catching. You ask for your rod and this kind of stuff, 7.4, 7.6, 7.3, heavy action. It's got to be heavy. Using braid, using fluorocarbon, that hook set has got to penetrate. It's got to get in there that first time you set back. The braid is a better choice. I like the fluorocarbon in the clearer water. Doesn't make a big difference. I'm catching fish on both. But that heavy rod, you got to have it. Casting reel, 65, 50-pound braid, maybe 60 gamma. 20, 25 pound fluoral, that's the minimum. You're pulling potentially big fish out of that heavy weed. Something's gonna give. You find a weak link in the chain, that fish is gone. Use good stuff and you're gonna catch fish in that deep weed. When you're fishing weed beds, you know what? Unless you got it totally pinpointed, little edges, cuts, you know, drop offs where the depth is changing, you gotta learn to just work it. You know, you just got to focus on dropping the bait in close to you. I'm not making long bomb casts. That's a big mistake when you're fishing that vertical, deeper weed. Closer to you, the better. I'd say about 10, 15 feet, work in an area because they're not going to travel real far to chase it unless they're suicidal or super aggressive. So you just got to learn to dissect it. Know that you're going to go in those weed beds. If you're at the right depths, you've had some bites, you know, you've had a history in some of those spots. Just get it into your head. I've got to work this back and forth vertically. When they bite, give them a second. A soft little rodent, perfect plastic, smells like coffee, lots of salt. They're not going to spit it out. You be patient, reel up any slack line, and give it to them. Because that first hook set, I got fluorocarbon. You can use the braid as well. That first hook set, very important. It's got to go through the side or somewhere. The metal has to eat the meat. That's those big ones in the deep weed right there. How good's he hooked, huh? Look at him go. That's what you call tough, tough bass. Look at him. Whoa, pull and drag, huh? That's a big bass. Get inside the mouth. I got him right there. That's the kind I want to get, the deep weed right there. I'd say he's pretty big, wouldn't you? That's why I fish deep clumps over and over again. I mean, you gotta stick with it, boy. That's what I mean right there. He's a big, big, long fish. Look what he's got in his mouth. Say hello, Mr. Rodent. Let's put him in here. That's what I mean right there. Deep weed is not a matter of just going out and finding a certain weed pocket, you know, and say, man, they were here yesterday or they're here last week. You gotta just gotta stick with it. Go from 7 feet to 12 feet, depending on what you consider deep. I'm not drop shotting, I'm using heavy casting gear, 20 pound fluoro, big 4-0 X points, you name it. Everything is big, because these fish are big. But you just gotta persistent, go at it. You know, you lose a few fish, that's just the way it goes in that deeper stuff. But you gotta figure out their position of where they are, how they move, what they're eating, and I guarantee it, you will catch them just like that. Regroup, retie, catch a few more. It's not a violent movement at all. All I'm doing is putting that bait out, falling it down, hits bottom, let's shake. Shaking it and baking it, letting them find it. When they grab it, those big ones, they don't let it go. Love the weed. The weed is where they are. Little guy. Little guys. Sitting with the big guys. Hold on. But you're munching it too, eh? Right through the side. Boy, oh boy. You want to eat. It's incredible. You know what? Sometimes you come out first thing in the morning, you say to yourself, I'm going to pound them. Because you're used to topwater fishing and, you know, throwing poppers and all that kind of stuff and thinking, morning bite's going to be nuts. And it can be. But sometimes you need that sun, a little bit of heat, some boat traffic to push the fish into where you want to catch them. And those weed edges, so they're not just roaming everywhere. I like when they tuck into the spots that they need to tuck into, and you put your little bait in there, that's when you catch them. So don't give up. You're in an area that you're positive as fish, you're catching fish, missing a few, don't worry. Those big ones take effort. Cottage Angler, tips and tactics to make you a better fisherman.
Hey guys, Strike Team Pro staff member Andy Montgomery. Got the new KVD Finesse spinnerbait. You know, this is a really compact spinnerbait, but it's still a good size. It comes with a half and a 3/8 ounce version. So you kind of compact your bait, it's gonna make it more snaggless. You're probably gonna get more bites, but you still got that weight so you can cast it good. It's got a light wire, and what that does, that creates a lot of vibration. You can actually see it in the end of your rod. It almost creates a thump, you know, almost like a little bladed swim jig or something. So you create a lot of movement, attract the fish in dirty water. You know, when I'm working the KVD Finesse spinnerbait, it's basically like any other spinnerbait. It's pretty much a steady wire. But I like to pop my rod every now and then, make them blades flicker, make them blades hit together. That's what's going to trigger the strike. Or running into a tree, running into a stump or something, that's what's going to trigger your bite. That's what's going to trigger that fish to react and actually bite the bait. It's got the perfect hook for the light wire. You know, if you got a light wire spinnerbait, you can't have too thick of a hook or you're not going to penetrate the fish's mouth when you set the hook. You know, when I set the hook on a spinnerbait, I want a little bit of upward movement in my rod. I don't want to come down here or you know, come straight sideways. I try to set the hook up. And what that does, that pops the hook up. You know, a hook's kind of parallel. You want it to pop up into the upper part of a fish's mouth. You're going to hook a lot more and you're going to land a lot more if when you set the hook, you raise your rod up. This hook's long enough and it's also thin enough that we get good penetration when a fish bites. It just hooks up extremely well with the head design. It rolls through cover good. This is just one of the best all-around spinner baits that Strike King's ever made.
When I'm fishing this stuff, you see me looking down a lot. Why? Because I'm watching those little contour edges, depth changes, something a little bit different that the fish might relate to. And when I catch a fish, I look right away at the depth. You know, you just start putting a pattern together because all the weed out here looks the same, but it's just subtle, you know, changes. Are they in 7 feet? Are they in 9? Are they in 12? Well, today it's been 12, 10. They're on that deeper edges. We had a cold night last night. You know, it's early August, but still, those cold nights can sometimes trigger them real heavy around those edges. You got to pay attention with your sonar, where you are, where you're getting bit, and keep repeating that. If it keeps happening, well, you're going to start catching more fish. And there you. I know you're down there. You ain't a big fish, but you are a fish hiding in the weeds. And you want to play with Papa, huh? Look what they're getting it again, in the cheek. I told you, man, it's just something else when bite, you're in the same spots and it's just like night and day. The fish move in, hey, did they? They turn on, something changed to make them go from looking at your bait, bumping the bait, pulling the bait off, to eating the bait. When you catch them in that weed, even with a 20 pound gamma like that, you gotta check it, man. Check the knot, hook point, everything's good to go. Let's keep going. You see what I mean about fishing deep weed? It don't matter. You can have the Edmund Fitzgerald floating by you. It doesn't bother the deeper bass. Now, if I was fishing docks right now or logs and stuff, I guarantee you those fish would not like that. When I'm here vertical fishing this weed, it don't matter. I can share the water with them and vice versa. We're all having fun catching bass. Oh, dropped at the boat. 5-pounder. You know, I'm gonna tell you some of the keys to catching big fish. It's not about different colors and buying the most expensive stuff. It's about paying attention to detail. You know, the right size, weight, line, hook that matches your bait. Always checking your hook points, checking your line, check your knots. The little things make a big, big difference when it comes to fishing, especially for big bass. You know what? Pay attention to the small things. The big things will come in the boat. Come here. Whoa. Another good one. About the same as the last one. Chunky, fat little bass. You see sometimes moving around. I wasn't getting too many again, that 12 foot. Came into the thicker stuff at about 9. That's about 3 pitches, 2 fish. And it just shows you sometimes, potentially, maybe, the real big guys will be in there too. But you know what? As long as I'm getting bit, that's what it's all about. Like I said, I want to come to deep weed to have some hook sets. Catch some fish today. I'm doing it. Keep going. I'm going to show you something. When I fish this weed, I'm not pitching very far. What I'll do is, a bit more line, or hold my rod up high and follow the line going down, just in case a fish, wham, on the way down. This is all about that vertical approach. Fishing those fish in the weed, almost directly below the boat, and right in front of you. So I love it, man. The deep weed is nice. You go to a dock, you know you're hunting those big fish. That's fun. But if you want some numbers, the deeper weed, man, off the bank, off the shoreline, you find it and you just, you know, figure out, are they in 12 feet, 15 feet, wherever you're fishing, 4 feet. In this case, 12 feet first thing, and then move into about 8 or 9, back and forth, some variety, catching some fish. That. Come here, you. Yeah. And that little bit thicker stuff, huh? Before you were out in the deeper stuff, and now you're in the thicker stuff. Look at that penetration. That's what you want right there, right through the top. Right just past the lip, too. He wasn't coming off. He's not a bragger, but I got a bragger. Let's let him go. Huh? You ready to go? Hey, big mouth, go on. Deep weed is the way to go for the numbers, and it's just variety. Variety is the key to fishing for me. Talk about fishing one weed bed over and over and over again. One waypoint, 3 o'clock, I'm almost done. But just dissecting, zigzagging all through this weed. Deeper stuff from 12 feet all the way up to 7, back and forth. Now I'm going to try a little bit in that middle, that 9 feet between. Got him in 7, got him in 10 and 12. Oh, just a chunker, huh? Just a chunker. Look at you. Just another fish to fill my day. Hey, look where you got it again. You cannot beat that when it gets to the side like that, man. You know he ate it. and you know he's coming in the boat. Just a little guy. He's a filler. A filler fish. A hook set, adrenaline pump, that's all. No size, nothing to brag home about, just a filler. Pretty good afternoon, huh? The rain's coming down, gotta get out of here. Deep weeds is another option for catching some numbers of fish, some decent fish, and hogs. Add that to your arsenal by fishing docks, logs, pads, trees, you name it. Deep weed is another option for you to use to catch fish, because you saw it right here on Extreme Angler TV. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time right here. This is what happens when you fish deep weed the right way. You get them big fat sows like that on Extreme Angler TV. In the wood, in the weed, on the docks, you name it. This thing on this show is why you're watching Extreme Angler TV. Let's let her go. Ready, big girl? Go on. Look at her. Look at her go. Gonna go under the trees. Beautiful big fish. Look at that. Big, fat, and healthy. So I can catch her next time on this show. Love it. Daiichi, world's sharpest hooks. Snag proof, a leader in weedless frogs. Gamma fishing lines. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.